Remember the fart blaster from Despicable Me? Well, they've turned it into a toy. And I'm gonna try and turn that into a farting minion robot. Yeah, this episode's gonna get weird. Let's do this. Farts. They're just always funny, and whoopee cushions have been making us giggle for years, but this Despicable Me fart blaster takes that toilet humour to the next level. Some might say it's gonna really blow you away. But let's see what this does. Shoots real fart rings. Lights and gassy action. It also comes with these little, like, liquid bottles, which essentially you fill up in here. Apparently there's two different scents. Banana flavor. Apparently this one has the fart smell. It's quite pleasant. Kind of smells like popcorn. Anyway, let's fire her up and see what it does. I think I'm gonna press this. Awesome. Let's give it a go. Oh. Ready? Ooh, what's happening here? Are you ready? That's what it does. Now, most of the time on Toy Teardown, after I've pulled apart a toy, I usually modify it in some way. Sometimes I make it bigger, other times I turn it into some kind of robot. So when this toy came out, I knew what I needed to do. A few years ago, I created a robot rubbish bin. So I figure the obvious thing to do is to insert this toy, turn the rubbish bin into a minion, creating the ultimate fire blaster. Then I figure I can just let it roam around and deliver the joy of fart smells to anyone in the area. Cause I'm mature and I feel like they'll really appreciate it. Before we do that, I gotta tear it down, see what's inside. Let's do it. Triangle screws. Usually a toy that doesn't want to be pulled apart. Oh. All right, let's see what's inside. Hey, hey, hey. Okay, cool. So first thing I've noticed is where we put the liquid in, which is actually just vegetable glycerin, is this section here. And it's just like a squishy bottle. So this trigger just pushes down. It literally just squeezes the liquid. It goes out, up into this tube, into this chamber here, and you can see there, there's some heating elements, which would be heating the vegetable glycerin and creating mist. Really similar to what was going on in the mixie toy, right? So that just squishes that up into that chamber. And then we've got our trigger mechanism, which is super cool. So the trigger, which sits here, I can just probably pull that off. There we go. That pushes this lever. This lever then pushes this part, which goes backwards, and because it's attached to a spring, as soon as it gets to its edge, lets go and pushes this membrane. And there's mist inside, so out the mist comes. Showing it working, as I press this, right, there's actually no fart sounds. And I think that's what this part is, right? So if I push this back, there you go. So this trigger is pulling this lever back, putting force here, creating the fart rings, as well as pushing this back, which is super smart. But the question I've got is, how does it actually create the mist rings? Let's find out. The mist rings coming out of this toy are called vortex rings, which are created when a fluid, which can be a liquid or a gas, is forced through a hole. The fluid rolls back onto itself into a donut shape or a toroid. So this toy is essentially an air cannon with mist and fart noises. I've got an air cannon here, and you can see the effect of how forceful these vortex rings can be. Invisible destruction. All right, so now that we know how this toy works, I'm gonna try and work out a way that I can automate it. Essentially, I want it to go off when it's within a certain distance from someone. So I've got the idea to put a ultrasonic sensor into the bin. It'll go off when they're within a certain distance, and then we will insert the fart gun in the backside of the bin robot.
Bottom.
But I think the thing that's kind of confusing me is this thing, in order to make vortex rings, requires force, right? So you've got to really squeeze that trigger to pull it back. So I'm gonna have to have a bit of a think about what we can do for that. Okay, how about, how much force does it need?
Nope.
If I have something that pulls it back, maybe? But then I'll have to take all this off. I'm just gonna do something else for now. While I try to work out what to do with that pesky trigger, I managed to revive my robot rubbish bin. Yay! Doesn't look much like a minion, so I think it's time for a makeover. Okay, so remember the too hard basket moment from before? Well, it turns out it was doable, but incredibly hard basket. A lot of this process actually happened off camera because it was over a couple of days. First, in order to move that lever, it needed a lot of force. So I did think a servo motor might be strong enough, so we inserted a servo, but the force from the lever just it wouldn't work, so it kept failing. So then I thought we'd go for a DC motor, which kind of worked. But also failed eventually as well. Then I thought, okay, what can we use that has a ton of force? And we came up with the idea for a solenoid. So this thing essentially has a pulling motion that snaps back into place as soon as current goes through it. The issue with that was that this is not on a spring, and every time it went back and pulled back out again, it essentially just fell straight out. Sorry, it was completely unreliable. So then we went back to the drawing board and I thought, okay, let's try this beefy thing. So this is a high torque DC motor. Doesn't mean it torques a lot, it essentially just means that it can handle a lot of force before it fails. So it's kind of like your standard DC motor is like the race car, so it's very fast but can't take a lot of force against it. This is very slow but can handle a fair bit of force. So then there's the problem of how to attach this thing, which is a round thing, to the handle of a toy, which is also curved. And we looked into mounting brackets and 3D printing parts and creating some kind of like foam mold. Tried all of that, didn't work. So we ended up with something that looks like this. Expanding foam. Kind of looks like I dropped it on my waffles, but look, it works. So we've got our 3D printed part here. I've had to add some wooden dowel inside that lever because it was also bowing and probably going to snap. I've had to drill a hole so that that can come straight from that pivot point. But as of now, it works. So it's about time that we installed this inside the bin and tried out our minion. hope it works. This took so long.
Cool.
Retrieve anyone? Here we have our robot farting minion. All that's left to do now is to unleash this beast onto the world. Before we do that, make sure you like and subscribe. Let us know what you thought about this episode. Until next time, see ya. Come on.